So Project Spark, in case you haven't heard, is an open world digital canvas. David's actually going to jump into our empty world and start doing some of the sculpting, kind of play around with some of our basic tools. But really, you can get into the game, you can create your own games, your own worlds, and your own story. So it really is a unique tool that allows users to kind of get in there and visualize those things that they've always wanted to make. So we're excited to be here in the AMD tent at CES 2014. And we're actually kind of we're double dipping on our AMD love, because we're cross platforms. We're on Xbox One. We're also on Windows 8, and both of those platforms actually utilize AMD technology. So we're excited about our Windows 8 build that we're currently seeing right now, which is using our the AMD Radeon R9 290X graphics processor. So the game looks and runs beautifully. So we're really excited about that. And so this is actually playing our live beta. So we have a beta right now that's going on. So people are it's a closed beta. So we'd love to have more people sign up at projectspark.com, but you can get in there, start seeing some of the awesome stuff our community is making. You can also kind of dive in and start making your own stuff. So as you can see, Dave is kind of going in and do some of our basic sculpting and painting. So you can see in a short amount of time, you can make something that looks really compelling and really awesome. And the really cool thing about our game is not only can you make something that looks cool, but you can also change the functionality and logic of everything in our game. We have every object has what we call a brain. And a lot of the objects have something called a default brain. So I think David's going to kind of show us a little bit about our brains in a moment here. And we'll see if we kind of jump through, and you can kind of get an idea for how you can take every object and make them do whatever you want them to do. So you show off the brains. So we have this. So this is Kodu. So Kodu is a when-do coding language that says, okay, well, when one thing's happened, do another. So like when A button is pressed, do jump. When the left stick is moved, do move. So it's really intuitive logic that you can kind of get in there and make whatever you want to make. Project Spark, it's all about our community. So our community are kind of, they're getting in there, and we can kind of see how our community is evolving. Being on the development team, as we're seeing the beta, and it's because it's a closed beta right now, so it's only going out to about a few thousand people. And they're getting in there, and we kind of see as they start to learn and grow in the tool and get inspired by other games, how more and more games are coming and being made that are awesome. When we start to introduce some of the other technology that that's going to be coming on board with our Xbox One beta, then it's going to be even more exciting. Something we're showing off here is our performance capture. So with our performance capture, people can actually record their full body animations. They can record their voice. They can record their facial movements, things like that. And so you can actually record those animations and put them in the game. So the amount of content that we're expecting to come out of that, the kind of games that could come out of that, the possibilities are really endless. So as our community starts to grow and evolve, we're seeing more and more impressive games and things that we didn't even know were possible from the development side. So it's really cool to kind of see what the community is evolving into, and the fact that you can start creating on one device and play on another device gives people the ability to, you know, really create on the go and then play when they get home. Or if your friend has an Xbox One and you're on Windows 8, you can create something, your friend can play it, or you can start creating on one platform, finish creating on another platform. So really, it's a lot of possibilities to kind of jump in and play around with the game. I'm really excited about the performance capture stuff. I don't know, it's just I love dance. I have a theater background, so I love kind of the dancing and the just kind of acting and putting those type of things in the game, because those are the kind of things that we don't have. We have our own, animations that our animation teams have built in our game. But just kind of seeing all the unique things that you can do, because you can actually tie your animation. So I can say, I can give a big gesture and I can tie that animation to a certain action that happens in the game. So you can play somebody's game and say, where'd they get that from? And so there's a sense of amazement and learning and just kind of a fascination that comes when you see all of this unique content coming into the game. So that's one of the things I'm really excited about.
CES is a wonderful time for us to get together and really talk about all of the innovations that are going to be important this year and in the coming years.